As soon as the tragic accident happened on the platform, we knew there was a spill that was ongoing. And with the revisions and the upward estimates for how much oil was coming out of the riser, that's when we knew we were pushing into a major spill. I'm part of a research team that is coming to Mississippi to assist our colleagues that are working on issues related to the oil spill.
Here at NISL, that's what our acronym is for the National Seafood Inspection Laboratory. We are an analytical laboratory which inspects the seafood consumed in the U.S. Today we went out to collect samples to establish baseline or background levels of petroleum contamination or petroleum hydrocarbons in fish species.
What you're trying to understand is the effect of something like an oil spill on the health of fish, or whether chemicals in the environment that are being taken up by fish or shrimp or something else are potentially going to be a threat to public health. And we live in a complex world, and so many of the kinds of chemicals that you might find in an oil spill come from other places. They can come from stormwater runoff, they can come from other human activities that are day to day. And so what we are trying to do is resolve a new input of oil into a coastal marine environment. And we're trying to understand how much of whatever we can measure in seafood is coming from that event versus how much of it was already here.
Today we found fish that were not obviously contaminated with oil. They passed one of the first tests, is that there's no obvious contamination. And so the next test is for us to take the fish in our system, and then they'll be tested for both sensory effects, as far as whether there's oil taint in the fish, and they will also be sent to our Seattle lab for chemical analysis.
And so what we're really trying to prepare for are the days when visible oil is receded or is no longer in certain areas. And we'll have a lot of questions about whether there's oil that you can't see, that it's been dispersed, or maybe it's subsurface, it's on the bottom, it's in tar balls. And we're going to want to know if there's any oil remaining, if that's something that fish are still exposed to.
And so that's what our function here is that we do those analyses for the Seafood Inspection Program to assure the safety of the seafood that's sold in the U.S.